What is up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode in our NASCAR Heat Evolution Career Mode. Today, we are going to be racing at Atlanta Motor Speedway for race number 2. Our first episode was our prologue, our second was Daytona, and our third is going to be at Atlanta. Our bank is at $823 because we went ahead and bought the garage space for $10,000. What that did is it unlocked the engine shop, which is $100,000, which that's not going to happen for a while. So now we unlocked basic milling, pipe benders, stamping equipment, and a CAD software, which that all adds up to $180,000 for all four of those. So we got a long way to go. My goal for this season, guys, is to just make the chase. I would love to make this chase. I feel like we can. We're sitting 23 in the standings right now. Junior won the last race, so he's already in. So we'll see. Let's see how this race goes. In the fall of 2001, Bobby Labonte won a race from the 39th position, the deepest starting position ever for a winner at Atlanta Motor Speedway. That is pretty cool. So we're still on hard difficulty, still on simulation mode. I am really sketchy on that right now, because I've had good things happen with it, and I've had bad things happen with it. So we'll just, we'll see how this race plays out with it, and it's going to determine, you know, how we keep doing it, I guess. It is a lot more fun than the normal mode, I must say, because that kind of gets old after a while. I feel like there's a lot more you can do on simulation mode. I feel like it gives you more freedom as far as throttle goes. Ooh, man, you can really feel those bumps right there. That is really neat. You can feel like the bumps going into the corner. I just hate the way it is, though, whenever you're like turning in. It always just bothers me so much. If you guys play the game, you know what I'm talking about. It just feels like it's swaying, or like the weight of the car is just fighting. Turning. It's frustrating. And we only get one lap, and I did not hit that corner the way I wanted to. That's great. So, this thing is one of the only tracks. Well, actually, I haven't raced that a bunch. Take that completely back. We've never raced here before. Well, I've never raced here before on this game. So, I'm not sure how the high line works, if there's enough space up there to run it. You know, 2-3 wide. 19th. That is awesome. Oh, I didn't adjust. Crap. I didn't adjust the race length. Crap. I really wanted to put that up to 13. So we can actually pit.
Hampton, Georgia, home of the Atlanta Motor Speedway. This is Rick Allen bringing you the Folds of Honor Quick Trip 500. The mania of Daytona is behind us, and now the regular season really kicks in.
I love Rick Allen's voice. Bam. Look how they did the intros. The intros are awesome in this game. I just wish they had like the cars rolling off. All right. So starting 19th. Blowing by some people right now. You can see Junior right there, the Daytona 500 winner. Oh my freaking god. Are you kidding me right now? Yes, we're gonna pit. Freaking ridiculous, man. Oh my god. You barely touch anybody, and you're done. Oh, I'm so frustrated right now. So frustrated. Still there. Oh my god. Really needed a good finish here today. I mean, we're just gonna race aggressive now and see what we can do. I mean, we lost a lot right there. We were running up in the top 15. And the outline is awesome. It's just so risky to run it. The engine's fucking blown. Sorry, I'm gonna restart the race, guys. Let's try this again. You know, after this, I'm just going to take what we're going to get, because I'm just blown away right now by this. You can barely race without blowing an engine every second. Like, look at that. Unbelievable. And I'm not doing anything wrong. They're just coming down on me, barely tapping me, and I'm wrecking. God, I hate restarting races. The incurment, I feel like it needs to be where you finish, it's where you finish. But in that case, man, I just didn't feel like that was fair, like I got screwed by the game.
Still there? All clear. You're all clear.
It's crazy. So we got a good run through two.
You're all clear.
We're just gonna haul the mail up through all here and just see what happens. Not the 31st. Man, I'm just so frustrated right now.
Clear low. Car low.
All right.
All clear.
Don't you do it. Up
to
26 already. This is crazy.
20 to go. All clear.
Okay.
All clear.
Up to 23rd. How does this work? I am so curious. Whenever they get like spaced out, the game's fine. When you start in tight packs like that, it is literally one of the worst things you'll ever experience in a NASCAR game.
Still there?
Oh, man.
All clear.
He says we're clear, and we actually were not. We are just whipping by these guys right now. That's because we got some fresh tires. Did we pit? I think we did.
All clear.
Oh, we got wrecked and we saved. That's what happened. Oh my god. Up the 20th. So this is pretty good. I'd be happy finishing right here. That's better than Daytona. And but honestly, I feel like we can get a top 15 though. Man, that run we get through 1 and 2. It starts bogging down. And I'm literally barely letting off the gas, and I don't see how I dropped that far down in speed.
Still there?
So it's starting to get harder to pass now since I moved my way up so fast. I mean, we passed half the field within a few laps. Just out of pure frustration. No. Oh my god, I thought I was gonna hit the wall. This track is a lot of fun to drive though on simulation. Like, it is a blast to drive. I feel like the bottom line may be faster for us. As you can see, that's where all the AI run though is down there. Might finally be able to get by these guys. Yep. Oh, he's trying to take us three wide. Jesus Christ. Up the 18th now. We're going to try to go on the outside of Kane. Then we're going to pick our moves here when we get to this other pack. How we want to get by him.
Stay on. Still there. All clear.
Oof. Mom, I had to get off a little bit there. Oh, somebody just wrecked behind us.
Car low.
Still just the cautions are so glitchy in this game. Sometimes there'll be a caution, sometimes there won't. Maybe we can actually run the bottom line right here. If Dylan doesn't... Oh my god. It's crazy. So still running in 19th. I mean, I'm happy with this. I just kind of like more...
Still there?
Especially seeing how fast we came up through here. We're kind of getting bogged down around these guys now. Yeah, they really start bogging down right there. But this game's, I mean, this game's fun, guys. It's fun to race. Just simulation mode could just be so annoying. I really wish they fix, like, the sensitivity of just, like, wrecking and stuff like that. Really frustrating. Because then you gotta restart races, and it's just annoying. I was not even clear low. If I would've went down low and he said so, I would've wrecked. God, he's really pushing on the inside of me right now. Alright, see, he got on the apron. If I would have done that, I would have been around. And that would have been over. We're gonna have to feather a little bit here. Don't want to get into the wall. Nice. It is fun racing like an underfunded team and stuff. Because we are back here battling for, like, you know, 16th place. It is fun. So I'm really looking forward to, like, next season. Running up front in the top 10 consistently. Racing for the wins.
Okay, that's the halfway mark now.
See, now at this point in the race, how everybody's spread out, it's actually a lot of fun racing right now. I just need to figure out a good way to do it in the beginning. Whether to just go up high and just wait it out, or... You know, I don't know. I need to figure something out for the beginnings. I can't keep wrecking like that. It takes about 8 laps to get organized like this.
8 laps to go.
And it's just easier to run the high side, guys, honestly, because they can't pinch you down on the high side. But if you're down low, they'll come down on you. Then it's either you touch them and wreck, or you touch the apron and wreck. There's no way around it. So you really gotta hold it down there, and then they control how fast you go, how far they want to pinch you down. So, I mean, there's that. So if you do play this game, that's just my experience of it. Can we clear Casey Kane in this corner? Oh, I had to get out of the gas a little bit. He says I'm clear.
Car low. Clear low.
Okay, cool. So let's try this bottom line. Let's not do the apron though. So that actually feels really good. I can probably run that wide open, honestly. Let's keep track of how far ahead these guys are. 2 seconds ahead right now. Oh no. Oof. Oof. Oh. Oh my god. Oh. That scared me.
Car high.
I was looking up. I should have been paying attention. See, he's gonna try pinching me. Oh, we get a really good run through there, though. Alright, so we lost a little bit on the guys up front because my stupid mistake there. Oh man, if I had wrecked, I'd have been so mad. It's so tempting though to go down there. That's how they get you. I'm trying to figure out how to enter these corners. Try a little bit wide, come down a little bit. That felt good right there. I don't think you're gonna be able to catch those guys up front. In front of me, honestly, Regan Smith and Ricky Stenhouse. It might be a little bit too fast for us at this point. See, and even 18 laps into the race, I just ran 1 and 2 wide open. Damn, got really loose there. I just ran that whole lap wide open.
5 laps to go.
So the leader, he's about 14.7 seconds ahead. So he's about half a lap ahead of us right now. Yeah, see, I just wonder who's leading. A lot of little things they can do this game to make it better. Is that lap traffic right there? Because I think we might be catching these guys now ahead of us. Yep, 1.7. I found the AI do deal with lap traffic pretty well though. They won't sit behind them for like laps and laps and laps. They'll actually, you know, pass them on the straightaways or at least try to get below them. Yeah, I gained about a second on those guys because of these guys right here. These guys. Let's try. Ooh, man, I almost hit that too early.
All clear.
There's Eric Jones. Let's try to get on the outside of McDowell right here. Ooh, he bumped me. I shouldn't have came down so early. Down to 1.2. Ooh, man, we might be able to catch Smith if we have more lap traffic. Oh man. Okay.
Here you go.
Oh my sweet mother. Oh my god. I'm gonna have to stand up and play this game. This is nuts. Almost lost everything. So the best option you can do in that is either let off the gas completely or just feather it. If you keep it held down, you're just gonna spin. That's literally the only ways to save it. Did he say 2 to go? Man, I keep wanting to get on the apron right there. I mean, there goes our chances to catch Smith, but still a 16th place finish for our second race on hard. That's awesome. Alright, coming into the last corners here. Run the high side, get around Ellis. Beautiful. Awesome. Speed rating of 87. Wow. That's better than I thought. We gained a bunch of fans, 350 fans. That's just quick math, guys. Look at that. Awesome. So who won? A lot of people lapped down. Wow, 26 cars. Joey Logano. Johnson finished second again. Oh my god. And Junior finished in the top 10. 5,500. And then another 5 grand. Awesome. So here's the point standings now. Ooh, I like how they do that. That's neat. So we're in 19th. I believe 16th is the cutoff point. Look at Danica Patrick about to get into the chase. Wow, so I think we can make the chase, guys. So again, the results, they go by really quick. And there you have it. Finish event. Yes, I want to leave the track. So, started off rough. We did have to restart the race because that incident there, but it ended up being awesome. That was a lot of fun. We picked up some new secondary sponsors. What? Check them out and make adjustments in the sponsor menu. Oh, baby. Let's check this out. What? This is awesome. You can earn extra cash during a race by displaying secondary sponsors and currently completing the requirements. What? Here at the sponsor page, you can adjust which secondary sponsor you want to display in your car. Some sponsors are willing to pay more, but expect more of it. As you progress, you'll have more locations to display these sponsors. Some locations are more valued than others, so choose wisely where you put a sponsor. That is really neat. Really neat. You know what? Let's lead a lap, that's not gonna happen. Qualify 20th? Hmm. Let's do the top 20. I feel like that's reasonable for us. And that's all we do, is just that. So we can just have one secondary sponsor at a time. So where do they show up on the... Interesting. So 11 grand, we need 20 grand for the milling equipment. So next race, we'll probably be able to buy that. Facility, look, we got one star. That's awesome. So we're stolen hard and all that good stuff. I think maybe next season, we'll do 13%. We'll just keep it on 7 for now. Wait, what just changed? Interesting, okay. So, that's it for this race, guys. I appreciate all the support on this series. This game's been actually a lot of fun playing. It can be frustrating at times, but it can be a lot of fun as well. Like, that race was a lot of fun there halfway through. A lot of fun just sliding around. But, thank you guys for watching so much. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you at Las Vegas.